Hello students, in last videos we did some elementary properties on groups, right? Like first property was identity is unique, and second was inverse is also unique. Okay. Then we did cancellation law. Cancellation laws hold in groups. Okay. Cancellation law holds in group. And also, then we did reversal law. Right? Reversal law. That is AB inverse is equal to B inverse A inverse. Okay. Now in this video we are going to prove some theorems on groups, right? So first theorem is theorem 1. If G is a finite group, okay, if G is a finite group of order n, that is, it means G is containing n number of elements, right? Then show that for any A belonging to G, there exists a positive number R such that where R is greater than 1 or equal to 1, less than equal to n, okay, such that a power r is equal to identity element, okay. Or this theorem can be stated alternatively. You could be asked, like, prove that in a finite group order of every element exists, right? So this could be alternate statement of this theorem, right? So now we are going to prove it, okay? So proof, firstly you see what we are given, hame kya kya diya gaya hai, okay? So firstly, G is a finite group of order n, that is order of G is equal to n. It means G is having n number of element, okay? And we are also given A belongs to G, right? And we shall prove that there exist R, positive integer R, such that A raised to power R is equal to E, okay, where this R is less than equal to n, greater than equal to 1, okay. So we shall prove that A raised to power R is equal to identity element, okay. So we know A belongs to G, right? Therefore A ए स्क्वेयर, ए क्यूब, ए फोर अप टू सो ऑन, ए रेज टू पावर एन, ए रेज टू पावर एन प्लस वन. दीज आर एन प्लस वन एलिमेंट. ऑल दीज एलिमेंट्स ऑल्सो बिलोंग्स टू जी. ओके, इज इट क्लियर? सो सिंस दीज एन प्लस वन एलिमेंट्स बिलोंग्स टू जी, इट मीन्स बट जी इज हैविंग, ओके, बाय यू कैन गिव रीजन बाय क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ग्रुप. क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी, ओके, बिकॉज सिंस ए इज द एलिमेंट, ओके, ए इज द एलिमेंट ऑफ जी, दिस इंप्लाइज ए स्क्वेयर इज ऑल्सो एलिमेंट ऑफ जी, ए क्यूब एंड सो ऑन. ओके, ऑल दीज एलिमेंट्स आर एलिमेंट्स ऑफ जी, राइट? बट जी कंटेन्स एन एलिमेंट्स ओनली. ओके, जी कंटेन्स एन एलिमेंट्स ओनली. दिस इंप्लाइज एट लीस्ट टू एलिमेंट्स, ओके, फ्रॉम दीज एन प्लस वन एलिमेंट्स मस्ट बी इक्वल. ओके, सो आई एम गोना राइट इट इन दिस वे. दिस इंप्लाइज at least two elements of these are equal. Okay, say AI is equal to AJ. Okay, say, and here I is greater than G. Okay, so this implies, now since AJ is element of G, therefore it must be having inverse also. Its inverse would be multiplying both the sides by its inverse, which would be A minus J. It would be AJ into minus J. It becomes E. So E is equal to E I minus J. So this I, see here, I was less than equal to n plus 1, okay, and greater than equal to 1. Here it was also n plus 1 se chota and greater than equal to this. So if we call this R, this is equal to E, and here since both the I and J are less than equal to 1, less than equal to n plus 1 and greater than equal to 1, therefore since both I and J is less than equal to, both I and J are less than equal to n plus 1 and greater than equal to 1, therefore R must be also, that is their difference must be also less than equal to n plus 1 and greater, their difference must be greater than equal to what? Less than equal to n, right? Okay. Okay. So hence the theorem, right? Or you write it in this way. Where R is less than equal to n and greater than equal to 1. Okay. Because I and J, I was greater than 1 and less than n plus 1. Right. When it would be getting subtracted, it must be lesser than equal to n and greater than equal to 1. Okay. So, thus, hence, the theorem. Okay. So, next result now, next theorem. Okay, it says let G be a finite group, finite group of, okay, only finite group. Let G be a finite group and A belongs to G, be an element of G of order N. Okay, then A raised to power m is equal to E if and only if n divides m. Okay, what does this sign means? Let me tell you here. It means n divides m properly, like 2 divides 4 properly, 4 divides 16 properly, 16 divide 32, 16 divide 64. Okay, this means this. But 3 does not divide 5, 3 does not divide 8. Okay, so we cannot use such sign for these sort of numbers, but we can use when 5 is dividing 15. Okay, we can use such sign for this. Okay, so here also n divides m properly. Okay, or alternatively you can say, what is n here? N is the order of n, right? So you can say, if a raised to power m is equal to e, if and only if order of A divides M. Okay, so what does this statement means? It means if A power something is identity, this implies, it means order of A divides M, right? Or conversely, if order of A is equal to M, this implies it was n. Okay, yeah, fine, it is M only. If order of A is equal to N, then N must divide, okay, or you can say A raised to power M is equal to E. Okay, so this is the meaning of the statement. So we want to prove it. Okay, proof. Since this is the if and only if statement, okay, given is, okay, firstly introduce what is G and A. Let G be a group, finite group. Okay, let G be a finite group and A belongs to G. Also, let order of the group is equal to N. Okay, order of A is equal to N. Now we shall prove that A raised to power M is equal to E if and only if N divides, or order of A divides M. Okay, it means इट मीन्स वी विल हैव टू प्रूव दिस इन टू पार्ट्स, नेसेसरी एंड सफिशिएंट पार्ट. ओके, इन नेसेसरी पार्ट वी विल बी एज्यूमिंग दिस स्टेटमेंट. ओके, ए रेज टू पावर एम इज इक्वल टू ई, एंड इन दिस वे वी विल बी रीचिंग एट द रिजल्ट दैट एन डिवाइड्स एम. ओके, वेयर एन इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ ए. इन सफिशिएंट स्टेटमेंट we will be assuming that n divides m, and in this way we will be reaching at the conclusion a raised to power m is equal to e. So this is the outline of the proof, okay, which we will be following in this case. Okay, so let's study the proof now. So I'm just writing all the things here only in one page, so that it would be quite clear for you, quite clear to you. Firstly, necessary part. Okay, in necessary part, we are going to assume that a raised to power m is equal to e. Okay, and we will be reaching at the result n divides m. Okay, so see here, it's not working, wait for a while. Okay, so let me fix this. Yes, now you see a raised to power m is equal to e. So what if we divide m by n? We will be getting some quotient and some remainder, right? And in this way we can write m is equal to nq plus r. So m can be written as using this is division algorithm theorem, right? So m can be written as nq plus r. You just write here division algorithm theorem, okay, in full form. Okay, m is equal to nq plus r. So see here, so in place of m I can write nq plus r. So a raised to power nq plus r is equal to e. Now breaking this, so it could be written as a raised to power nq into a raised to power r is equal to e. Okay, now let me erase this. Okay, now you see, since order of a is equal to n, it means a raised to power n is equal to e. If I raise its power again to q, it would be e raised to power q, which is equal to e into e into e is equal to e again. So this thing is equal to e. Okay, e time a raised to power r is equal to e. So this means a r is equal to e. Now we know what is the definition of order, and here r is, okay, according to division algorithm theorem, r is less than equal to by what we are dividing, that is we are dividing, okay, strictly less than n and greater than equal to 0. Okay, so see, this r is less than n and greater than equal to 0. But what is the property of order? Order is the smallest. What is order? Order is the smallest number. Okay, smallest number such that a raised to power that number is equal to e. But we know order of the a is equal to n. Okay, एंड आर इज द स्मॉलर देन एन, विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑर्डर ऑफ द ए इज गिवन, गिवन दैट ऑर्डर ऑफ द ए इज इक्वल टू एन. सो आर इज द स्मॉलर नंबर देन स्मॉलर नंबर देन एन. सो दिस इज वायलेटिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ऑर्डर. ओके, दिस वट कुड बी, दिस इम्प्लाइज आर मस्ट बी इक्वल टू जीरो. इफ आर इज इक्वल टू जीरो, इट मीन्स एम इज इक्वल टू एन क्यू, विच इम्प्लाइज सी एन डिवाइड दिस नंबर, राइट? बिकॉज एन इज प्रेजेंट हियर, वी कैन डिवाइड इट बाय एन एंड वी विल बी गेटिंग कोशेंट एज क्यू. सो देयर फोर दिस थिंग इज इक्वल टू एम, सो वी कैन राइट इट एज एन डिवाइड्स एम. ओके, मीन्स ऑर्डर ऑफ ए, और यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट ऑर्डर ऑफ ए डिवाइड्स एम. ओके, सो दिस इज द नेसेसरी पार्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू द सफिशियंट पार्ट. सफिशियंट, यू जस्ट राइट इट वन बाय वन. ओके, सेकेंडली यू राइट दिस. नाउ सफिशियंट पार्ट, सो इन सफिशियंट पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू एज्यूम दैट. ओके, दिस वॉज आर एजम्पशन. ओके, एज्यूम दैट n divides m. Okay, so if n divides m, this implies m can be written as n into q. For example, if 2 divides 10, we can write 10 is equal to 2 into 5. So similar is the case here. So n is dividing m, so m can be written n into q or n into something else, n into k. Okay, n into q, k. So this implies a raised to power m is equal to a raised to power n k, which is equal to, okay, which is equal to a raised to power n into, it can be written like this. We know order of a is equal to n, which means a raised to power n is equal to e. So e raised to power k, which is equal to e again. This implies a raised to power m is equal to E. Okay, hence the theorem. Okay, thus a raised to power m is equal to e if and only if n divides m, or order of a divides m. Okay, hence the theorem. Okay, so this was very important theorem. I just want you to note one thing from here, which is if order, if a raised to power m is equal to e, this implies order of a divides m. I want you to note this point. Okay, I want you to note this point. If order of a raised to power m is equal to e, this implies order of a must divide m. Okay, or you can say if a power k is equal to e, this implies order of a must divide k. Or alternatively, we can write if a raised to power n is equal to e, this implies order of a must divide n. Okay, now last theorem, theorem 3. Okay, it says if G is a group and A belongs to G, has order n, then then what could be order of a raised to power k? It is equal to m dividing gcd of m and k. Okay, gcd of m and k. Firstly, I'll tell you what is gcd. Okay, assume two numbers, right? 12 and 16. GCD stands for greatest common divisor. Okay, see here, you are having two numbers, 12 and 16. What are divisor of 12? 1, 2. 1 and 2 are divisor of 12. 3 is also divisor of 12. 4 is also divisor of 12. 6 is also divisor of 12. And 12 itself is a divisor of 12. So see here, 1 is divisor of 16, 2 is divisor of 16, 3 is not divisor of 16, 4 again is a divisor of 16, 5 is not, 6 is not, 7 is not, 8 is divisor of 16, 9 not, 10 not, 11 not, and now 16 is the only divisor of 16. Okay, now common divisor, which are the common divisor of these two numbers? So see, 1 is the common divisor, 2 is the common divisor, and 4 is the common divisor. Now greatest common divisor, which is the greatest of these? So this is 4. So greatest is 4. So we write greatest common divisor of 12 and 16 is equal to 4, right? Also, you just note one thing. If 4 is the common greatest common divisor of 12 and 16, it means 4 divides 12, 4 divides both 16. One is this, one property is this. Second property is whatever is left after the division, right, like you will be left 3 here after division, and you will be left here 4. Now, what is the common greatest common divisor of these two numbers? It is equal to 1 always. This is the property of greatest common divisor. Okay, so I just want you to note this somewhere in your notebook. Okay, I'm erasing it. So this is what is common divisor. Okay, okay, so proof now. We have to here G is a group, let G be a finite group. Okay, it is not same. We don't need to write finite here because this theorem is also true for infinite group. Okay, G be a group and A belongs to G such that order of A is equal to N. Okay, now we shall show that or prove that order of a power k is equal to m dividing greatest common divisor of m and k. Okay, we have to show this. So firstly, assume that let order of a raised to power k is equal to t, and GCD of M and K is equal to D. Okay, so if this is the GCD of M and K, this implies D divides M and D divides K. Okay, which implies if D divides M, M can be written as M1 into D, some M1 into D, and this can be written K is equal to K1 into D. Okay, so this implies दिस इम्प्लाइज एम इज इक्वल टू एम वन डी एंड के इज इक्वल टू के वन डी फॉर सम एम वन एंड के वन. ओके, फ्रॉम हियर यू सी वट इज योअर एम वन. एम वन इज इक्वल टू एम वाई डी. ओके, सो नाउ यू सी वी शैल शो दैट ऑर्डर ऑफ ए रेज टू पावर के इज इक्वल टू एम बाई ग्रेटेस्ट कॉमन डिवाइजर ऑफ एम एंड के. दिस इज इक्वल टू टी एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू डी एंड सी एम बाई डी इज इक्वल टू एम वन. सो देयर फोर वी शैल शो दैट दस वी नीड टू प्रूव दैट दिस इज टी. ओके, t is equal to m by d, but m by d is equal to m1. Okay, m1. So we need to prove that t divides m1. Okay, how we are going to prove this? We are going to prove this using in one part we will be proving that t divides m1. In second part we will be proving that m1 divides t. Okay, if these are dividing each other, it means t is equal to m1. Okay, so firstly you see order of a raised to power k is equal to t, which means a k power t is equal to e, right? This implies a power k t is equal to e, but we know, okay, but order of a is equal to order of a is equal to m. Okay, from last theorem states that if a raised to power something is equal to e, this implies order of a divides that something. Okay, so this implies m divides kt. Okay, we know m is equal to m1d and k1d in place of k, t, d, d cancel. So this implies m1 divides k1 t. See what was the these were the two numbers, right? M and k. Okay, their greatest integer were d. Greatest common divisor were, sorry, their greatest common divisor were d. After dividing these two number by d, we will get, because it is m1d and this is k1, after dividing we will be getting m1 and k1, like we were having, okay, similarly to 12 and 16, like their greatest common divisor is 4. After dividing them by 4, we will be getting 4 and 3, like here we will be getting k1 and m1. So their common divisor is greatest common divisor is 1 only. It means they do not divide each other, right? So same is the case here, m1 does not divide k1 and k1 does not divide m1. Okay, so here m1, here m1 is dividing k1 and kt, but m1 does not divide k1. It means m1 divides t, right? So m1 divides t. So this was the first part. Now in second part we will be probing t divides m1. Okay, let me erase this. सेकेंडली यू जस्ट डोंट राइट दिस इन माई वे, यू जस्ट राइट इट स्टेप बाय स्टेप. ओके फर्स्टली विच आई एम राइटिंग फर्स्टली, यू राइट इट अबव द सेकेंडली सेकेंड पार्ट. ओके आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग इन इट इन दिस वे सो दैट इट कुड बी इट आई कुड सिंप्लीफाई इट फॉर यू. ओके सिंस यू नो ऑर्डर ऑफ ए इज इक्वल टू एम, therefore a raised to power m is equal to e. okay and now if I raise its power to k1, it would be again equal to e raised to power k1, which is equal to identity element. okay now I can write m k1 is equal to e. again m can be written as m1 d k1, which is equal to e. okay so now clubbing these d k1, okay we get m1 k is equal to e. now we can write it as a raised to power k m1 is equal to e. we know but order of a raised to power k is equal to t, so this implies t divides m1. okay so this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2 from 1 and 2 we get m1 is equal to t. okay so see here t is equal to m1, t was equal to order of a raised to power k and m1 is equal to m divided d and d is equal to greatest common divisor of m and k, hence the theorem. Okay, hence the proof or theorem. Okay, so this is it for today. Rest of the things will be done in next video. Thank you.